Hi, and welcome to Spice and Pans. Today we'll be cooking Singapore style chicken chop. So let's start cooking. Now we are going to butterfly the boneless chicken leg. This is how it's supposed to look like. Very thin. Okay, I'm going to show you how I do this. Today I'm making lunch for three. Hence I'm using three pieces of boneless chicken leg. One piece is approximately between 220 to 240 grams. I'll show you how I butterfly them. Skin side down. At the center here, you just slice down about halfway through and turn your knife this way and slice it through like this. Be careful not to cut your hand. Slowly do it. The purpose why I'm butterflying this is because when you cook chicken, the meat will actually shrink and this will make it look bigger. And of course, the marinade will get in much easier. So about 3/4 through, just turn the meat up a little bit and then slice through again. Be careful not to cut through the meat because we want the whole piece to be intact. Right, something like this will be good. Now for the other side, same thing. Place your knife flat like this and start slicing through. About 3/4 through, just flip it like this and just slowly slice it through. Okay, it's just that easy. So let's marinate them now. So these are the three boneless chicken leg and we are going to marinate them now. You add in 3 tablespoons of light soy sauce. 2 tablespoons of oyster sauce. 1/2 teaspoon of sugar. The reason I'm putting in sugar is to balance up the taste so that it's not just a one-dimensional saltiness. Add in also 2 cloves of crushed garlic. And a few dashes of crushed white pepper. Wash your hand and then we'll use our hand to mix all this up. Once you have mixed them up nicely, we'll just put them in the fridge and let them marinate for at least 2 hours. Remember to bring them out and rest at room temperature for at least 1/2 hour before you cook them. I'll see you back in a while. Now we'll prepare the gravy for the chicken chop. Using a saucepan or a small pot, turn the heat to medium low or low. Add in 20 grams of unsalted butter. Add in also 1 teaspoon of crushed black pepper. Add in also 1/3 of a chicken stock cube. Mix them up well. Remember not to turn up the heat way too high because we do not want to burn the butter. Add in also 8 grams of plain flour. Mix them up well. We will need to brown the flour. Remember to keep stirring it. Stir until the flour is fully incorporated into the butter. And we'll fry them until they are brown. When they are brown like this, add in 200 milliliters of water. Stir them up really, really well. And we'll cook this to the consistency that we like. I like my sauce to be darker, so I'm adding in 1/2 teaspoon of dark soy sauce. Stir it up. Remember to keep stirring it. Otherwise, this will burn very easily. If you want your sauce to be darker, feel free to add a little bit more dark soy sauce. Make sure that the dark soy sauce that you use is not overly salty. Okay, I think this is the consistency that we want. We'll turn the heat off right now and just set this aside. We are going to pan fry our chicken chop now. Heat up a pan using medium heat. Add in just a little bit of oil, not too much. Alright, just swirl the oil around a little bit. Put in your chicken chop. Lay the skin side down first. Make sure you spread them out nicely like this. You'll fry them around 4 minutes per side. Using your spatula, just press it down a little bit. You want to brown the chicken so that the flavor will be better. Now remember, don't turn up the heat too high. Because if the heat is too high, you'll burn the chicken chop easily. And of course, the meat in the middle will be raw. I'll now flip the chicken to the other side to see whether it's brown to the color that I like. This is exactly how I want it to be. Very brown and a little bit charred. We'll just need to cook the other side. Same thing also, 3-4 minutes will be good enough. I'll just flip it now to the other side just to have a look. Right, now it's cooked, We'll just put this aside and now we'll go and fry our French fries. We're going to fry our French fries now. Heat up a wok of oil. I'm using medium-high heat now. When you put in your chopsticks and you see bubbles rising up, then the oil is hot enough. We'll now add in our French fries. You can cook however much French fries as you want. We are doing a little bit more because we really love fries. And I bought this from supermarkets, so it's actually store-bought. I will maintain the oil at medium-high heat. Now, don't move the fries around first because I want them to harden a little bit before I move them around. Otherwise, you'll break them up easily. Just let it settle down for at least about 1 to 2 minutes before we move them around. About 2 minutes is up. We'll now just gently move them around so they are heated up evenly. And the fries are beginning to harden up already. I believe another 2-3 minutes and it will be done. We'll fry them until they are slightly golden brown. We want our fries to be really crispy. You can actually hear the sound if you were to move your chopsticks around and hit them a little bit. You can hear kind of a hollow kind of knock, like tok tok tok. Our fries are almost done. Now for the last minute, I would like to turn it up to high heat so that I can force the excess oil out of the fries. Our fries are now ready and we'll remove them from the oil. Remember to salt your fries before you serve them. Next, I'll show you how I fry the buns. Now I'll fry the buns using medium heat. I'm using butter rolls over here. Of course, if you want to toast them, you can toast them. In Singapore, the Western food store usually serve the buns deep fried. So we are just going to put it in. You don't have to fry them for very long. So I'm just going to maintain them at medium heat. I'm using the same oil that I fried the fries with because it gives the bun a very nice buttery taste. Remember to constantly just turn them around. All right, this is done. So now we just remove them from the oil. Now our dish is done. Let's enjoy our lunch. And now the dish is done, let's have a taste. Oh, smells good. The marinade in the chicken, really, really wonderful. The gravy really brings this dish to another dimension of flavor. So ladies and gentlemen, I hope you like our video. Do click like on our video and do subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.